Hi, I have another quite fun video here with me beating the heart, this time with the Watcher, I believe, on Ascension 5. So the video was recorded a couple of days ago, and I couldn't comment, and it was in the middle of the night, and I had a sleeping baby in the room next door. So I'll try to fill you in on the details now. So this combat is going to be quite dependent on power cards. Various power cards that give us block. And we have some apparitions here too that we play. We have a spoon that can give us a chance to reuse these exhaust cards. So the idea is there is to get the apparitions back. But we're going to play power cards to get block from being in calm, block from scrying cards, if that's how it's pronounced, and so on. So we'll see how it goes. I believe the only damage I take in this combat, we'll see if I'm right, is kind of self-inflicted from misremembering that the heart has the beat of heart ability, which gives you a damage or two whenever you play a card. So I sometimes forget to put up some block before I'm playing my first card. So it's kind of again kind of toying with the heart here, but it's a combination this time of the apparitions and a lot of sort of block for free eventually whenever we stay in calm in particular, or scry cards, which we will do all the time. We also have a unceasing top relic, which will allow us soon. I will play a power card, I believe, that will give me more and more. I don't have the name of the card, and we'll see it soon. I think that gave us more and more energy every round, so we will approach something like an infinite deck, but we will not really get there. But we will play a ton of cards eventually per turn. So we'll see here. No damage yet. The heart is attacking for 30. I also have a bottle there with a fairy, so have a 4 to go down to HP 0, but I believe I didn't lose much HP here. Even forgot to use most of those potions, I believe, but again, it's such a good deck that I could afford to be as sloppy as I was here, playing in the middle of the night. So there we have no damage. Will be some times I remember to take sort of pause to think a bit whether I want to play more cards or not. Since by scrying you will see what cards are coming up, sometimes you would rather keep them for the next round rather than keep on pumping out cards and using the unceasing top. Alright, so one damage there, I didn't see where it came from. I believe it was from a played card. Looks like it was only 1 HP. So again, the apparition's coming to rescue, and there's Spoon saving it, the Deva form. An upgraded one. Quite many upgraded cards here. So I've taken the fusion hammer relic, which allowed me to not will, or which takes away my ability to upgrade cards by the fireplaces. But I used a lesson learned that you might have seen, and a really good card that upgrades any card at random in your deck permanently. Not a little bit like the armaments for the ironclad. I thought this one was pretty fun. The Watcher is the newest character, of course, in Slay the Spire, so perhaps not so many strategies out for her yet. But it's a really cool character. You see, I'm staying mostly in. Right now we have 7 auto-block when we're in ending a turn in calm, so I even hesitate there to play the empty body, even though it would give me quite much energy. We'll see here if I played it or not, I don't remember. And there I see we have the apparition. We save that for the next turn. Windmill Strike, I believe, we retain to build up damage. Yep. We also have a relic there, the last one. Cloak Clasp that gives us a block for every card we still have in hand. A lot of other things that generate. We will also see some turns that we have massive amounts of dexterity. It's from the Duality that gives a temporary dex per card played, and the Kunai that gives a permanent dex upgrade whenever you play 3 attacks. So we have a LIke Water, another power card that gives us another 14 if we just end the turn in the calm stance. Windmill Strike up there. So the meditate card there lying in, I think we get it out now. Didn't go super well. I think I took it from earlier, couldn't get rid of it, but it actually ends a turn, which is not great when you have the Unceasing top. So that one I would maybe remove, but it was good as some. I had some ideas with it, but it's pretty fun because I didn't really know where I was going with this deck for a long time, and then it's kind of ended up. It's a huge deck with 47 cards, and ended up being good anyway. Sometimes it works, most often, otherwise it feels beneficial and more better to just focus on an idea early. So you see now we get an extra, already up to 12 energy per turn from that Deva form earlier. So now we're almost infinite, lost 4 HP. I missed when it happened now, but you probably saw it. And then we can use the scry ability to get rid of these annoying status cards that the hearts inflict upon us. But you see ridiculous amounts of block and damage per turn, even though most cards are nothing special really. Can't play a ton of them. Lost an apparition there. It's a mistake. But again, no damage from that huge attack. Had I had that apparition, I wouldn't have taken any damage here, but let's see if I manage to dig it out. It's also the scry can help you dig. And that's what I'm going for here. See, I believe I was lucky to get one out eventually. Another apparition, that is. We got another protect there, at least with a lot of block. And there we got the apparition. Not too many left here now. Lesson learned, I played it earlier in this battle. You saw the first minutes, but Spoon retrieved it. Alright. Not much left now, but or a little bit more than halfway, so soon gonna be over. Hey, see there, ridiculous amount of dexterity. It's built up now with the kunai. Yeah, and then have the, what is that card called? Well, the card that gave us mantra. So we get into this triple damage stance. Times 15 damage. Well, we have 13 energy to waste still, and an unceasing top, so if I recall correctly, this won't be a problem. Maybe we have to shield this block, and all the apparitions could be gone at this stage. We're exhausted, I'm not sure. We weaken, but he has this hard artifact. So every time we scry, we get 8 block as well. It's a pretty fun, like, it's sort of a combination of the defect video I put up last time. We quite easily, just as a consequence of playing cards, build up ridiculous amounts of block while. Of course, the defect was more or less completely passive using orbs. But yeah, with unceasing top and all of these status or power cards activated, you can get a similar effect. 8 damage so far. Let's see here. The wound is a bit annoying, but manage anyway thanks to the 16 dexterity there we had when we played some of the block cards. And we enter triple damage stance again. This could be the turn when it's over. Well, we have the void there, we don't think we can get rid of that. Or just cry out something. Meditate something out here. No reason. End the turn. Oh yeah, the windmill strike probably, because yeah, the heart has only 13 hit points left at this stage. That would ensure the victory. Actually 10 damage was more than I thought. I would have to look over this video again, but I think it's all self-inflicted. Might be one or two hit points from the heart, but yeah, pretty fun combat and fun character, the Watcher. See now if it was, I think I kept this until the high score screen recording. You can see if it was Ascension 5 or 6, I believe I only played A6 with the Ironclad yet and I unlocked them with the others. So yeah, Ascension 5. Good score also, 1626. So yeah, that's that. Just another short toying with heart video. Going off for a vacation now for a while, so no more Slay the Spire for me in a week at least or so. But I hope you're having a fun time, and especially if you're playing Slay the Spire. So see you some other time. Goodbye.